So everybody that's responsible for an outside duty, Crook, Williams, you guys should head out at 2:05. Anybody have any questions and or concerns? Teachers picking up from the gym and the lunchroom, you guys have to have those kids picked up this year, about 2 minutes before 8. Pick them up about 2 minutes before 8. These folks are not even able to get started because we're taking longer to get our kids, and it's taking us too long, we're coming up 1 minute late. So pick up every day this year. Pickup will be 7:58. So everybody understand that doesn't affect your team, Turner. That affects 3 through 6, 7:58. Still, do not mark kids late until 8:01. D.
Are we still making sure that the kids pick up their siblings at the flagpole? Because if they stand on that brick, then we don't have kids running all around in that back. And then siblings know to come directly to pick up their, older siblings know to pick up their the little ones and head on up that hill.
Can you tell them what you want? Are you the flag, you're not the flag bearer. Who's the flag bearer?
Well, it was Mr. Houston and Ms. Beckford. Yes, sir, Ms. Shaw. They were the flag bearer. I was just shooing them.
Okay,
but
what she's saying, stand up and tell them exactly what you're saying, because this dismissal affects largely everybody in the back.
When your students come out, if they're to meet with their siblings, they must stand on the brick around the flagpole. And if they have an extracurricular activity, they are to stand on the brick. They are not to run around. And I've been telling them that if they get off that brick and they have an extra curricular activity, they're going home. They cannot get off that brick until the supervisor, whoever's supervising the activity comes to pick them up, to walk them back in the building. And then the siblings, when they come out to see, I'm noticing we're coming out later. So the little people should be on that brick. So by the time 2:11, they come out, they grab their sibling and they head on up that hill. So all siblings are to be on the brick at the flagpole.
You guys all understand that. Doctor, I'm sorry.
Want the primary to be on the brick too, but we need to keep our kids until the siblings come and time.
See, I don't know about that.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, then in that case, when they see some of the siblings were walking up the hill with their teacher, and so what I did is I made my 5th and 6th graders stand on the brick until their teacher came back down with the little ones to meet their siblings.
So are you asking about the kids that are coming back down, like Childs, and or are you asking about the kids in the gate?
That's fine. And see, and I had to stop that because I had friends and cousins and all that going all into that gate to sign them out. No, only one child who was supposed to be the person signing out the student. They come and sign them out and then they head on up that hill. So if somebody's signing somebody out, they go ahead and sign them out and head up the hill. But if you're waiting for a third grader, the third grader should be on the brick until the 5th and 6th grader come out. The 5th and 6th grader comes out now at 2:11, grab that third grader off the brick and head on up that hill.
The people who are back there, I hear you back, give me 1 second. The people who are back there, this especially that group right around the flagpole, Houston, it gets crazy back there. If we're on point with that back there, we can get them out of here faster. Like, we got a pretty much a better system in the front. But most of our kids are on the bus, on the van. You guys have moving traffic constantly. Once we get our kids down to Hustle, she's just kind of moving them along down the street. But we have more like an underground railroad. We got more of a city. You guys got, it's chaos back there, and it's nothing. We got to tighten that part up so I hear exactly what
you said. We used to, a couple years ago. When they stood on that brick, it worked.
It did.
We have to make sure that anybody who has a sibling, not a cousin, not a friend, not a neighbor, they get on up that hill. Sibling, if you are waiting for your sibling, you stand on the brick.
If you stand and wait for your sibling, period, not with your friend.
Right.
Not with your friend and them. It just gets tricky.
I think the confusion as well is the after school program. You know,
program just of kids, why don't we just move them to the lunchroom? Why can't, then they're, because the rub is when all the kids outside. So let's start not allowing Jet's kids to go outside. If you're Jet, you need to come down with the busers and the walkers. That would be the new music that we're playing.
That I'll make sure that teachers have a list of our students that are in those.
Right, Jets need to stay inside. That would bring 25, 30 kids in. It's crazy out there.
You have too many children out there.
I promise you guys, if we tighten it up, and she is right, when we had everybody on the bricks, get your sib and move on, now it's, that's my cousin and them, it's too much. So let's just get our arms around that.
When is Jets gonna start?
We don't start until September 5th.
First day.
Huh?
September 5th
is a Tuesday, that's our first day. All right, guys, any more questions? And Ms. Crystal, and then.
With the vans and busers, we've lost staff who always did that with me.
No, you did, whoever.
Roth was vans and Ingram was with me on buses. So Mr. Commissioner
Carlin. And Ms. Grace, Ms. Grace.
Stop thinking about his grocery list. He's your man. So you'll have to train him up.
And Ms. Grace.
And Ms. Grace.
And Ms. Grace. Ms. Grace. And Ms. Grace is happy to be here. She'll do whatever. So, yes. Grace. She's Ms. Grace, raise your hand. Because I need hustle in. She's my.
That's our neighborhood right there. We need her.
You said the bus drivers and the after school kids will go down. Do we have maybe
10
kids that are in that?
We
send them all down on their own?
This is what I would do if I'm partnered with Graf. I would have Graf take everybody that's going down, and I would do the dismissal. That's just what I would do. But that will mean one teacher will probably have a heavier load. So if you have the walkers, Ashley and Grillier are walking. They're third. Let's say third grade teachers, I would have one person that's taking everybody that is going to the cafeteria. And that might, between the two classes. But you may end up going outside with 30 kids.
We had so many bus riders and they were getting an issue, so you were doing bus duty, so you'd lock them down.
She can.
So maybe, right?
She can. You guys can work your hand like who you have at the end of the day with you all. You can work your hand. But make sure to do not just send them down there. We're not prepared to receive them. There's often no one there from Jets. It can get scary. So when they come down, let them know also if Rogue is the person that's walking the kids down the cafeteria. She's managing those kids. She's not walking them down and just running off. So my expectation, mine at this point is when we have kids down there for Jets and for your team, you, Ms. Jackie, you guys should come down there and the teachers are down there. So you guys should work that out in your meetings. Michelle?
Well, last year we took half of our kids up the hill and the other half we left up by the flagpole because their parents and siblings picking them up and then they'll go directly around the pre-primary and go home that way. So whoever is going to go up the hill and go home in a different direction, we took them up there. So I'm just wondering.
That's what I'm asking. That's what I'm saying.
Is that something that we need to keep everybody by the flagpole?
No, not everybody. Right. Just the people who are waiting for siblings.
Right.
That says continue to walk up to the top. You're people who are not waiting for anyone.
But then we have kids up the hill waiting for their siblings also.
They shouldn't, because then you have the siblings who don't know where their siblings are running back up and down to the top, to the bottom, to the top. So if everybody who is waiting on a sibling stand at that flagpole, then you know to meet your little sister at the flagpole and head on up the hill.
Okay, we can do that too.
So you guys can work on what